Digital leaders, you've created a great digital roadmap and project plan with milestones for delivery, but how do you deliver on these milestones in an agile manner? More importantly, how do you inspect and adapt your digital delivery for business needs? Most leaders want to have a line of sight on how the digital roadmap is unfolding. However, the right systems and governance structures are not set in place, making it very difficult to justify the economics of digital efforts to key stakeholders. Agile practitioners may want everyone to believe in self-managed and self-organizing teams, but in reality, executives will hesitate to buy in on an emergent style of delivery. This hesitation is because they fail to answer executive questions that are more financial in nature. Questions such as, can we be more predictable on software delivery? Can there be cost reductions on how we deliver software to the business? Can we get to market faster? Are we building the right digital services and competitive products? To answer these questions, an agile, practice-driven approach does not always work. What I mean by a practice-driven approach is trying too hard to change the mindset of the whole organization or trying to go through the motions of Scrum to be more agile. These approaches often end up failing to address barriers such as technical debt and existing culture within the company. In this video, we talk about three principled approaches or actions that digital leaders can take for an agile roadmap execution. If you like these videos on specific topics, give us a thumbs up or consider subscribing to our channel. Now, back to our principles of agile project execution. Firstly, evaluate and create encapsulated agile teams. Look at your environment and organize organization patterns to ultimately create teams that are encapsulated. Encapsulated teams are given a certain level of autonomy with minimal dependency. For example, you may have a microservices team that may provide core capabilities throughout the organization. You may have a feature team that is consuming those services and visualizing it, and so on. The idea here is to create the right underlying systems of delivery and enabling entities within the enterprise to adopt an agile practice. The second principled action is establishing governance. By this, we mean forming the right leadership coalition within your team to execute. Having a governance structure will enable you to inspect, adapt, and recommend economic trade-offs as your digital building progresses. For example, you may have an executive committee that listens to the executive team on strategy progression and advocates for technology-based business value realization. You can have a program committee that can ensure resource availability, allocation, report on the health of projects, and agile delivery. An enterprise architecture committee can offer oversight on aligning technology architecture with business architecture and ensure uniformity of solutions. The third principled action is to gain feedback from business stakeholders on shipped software. We're not talking about sprint reviews or retros here. What we are really talking about is developing an effective change management process that engages with the business users or customers to continually gain understanding of the value of digital delivery. The questions you want to answer here are the digital artifacts affecting the metrics and the KPIs you developed? Are they producing the business outcomes that you had planned to achieve and deliver? To sum up, we are talking about three principled actions for an agile execution. One, creating the right encapsulated agile teams that can deliver incrementally and iteratively. Setting up a governance structure to inspect and adapt. Finally, engaging business with a change management process that can measure outcomes.